is banning.
Why do you ban Alice? Let me think.
What
do you want
to
do?
What are you trying to set up here? That's the better question.
Yeah, if you ban Alice, that means you want to dive, right?
Potentially? I think they are expecting...
You want to pick Minotaur.
Or they're expecting Bigatron to pick Minotaur.
But then why wouldn't they pick Alice himself?
That's true.
Well, straight away, mind games off the bat.
Huh, that's definitely different. Something else that RRQ has pulled out of their pocket. Not too sure why exactly, but we might get a better idea once the draft continues. Last couple of seconds here.
Oh, great.
Lunox
open.
Lunox
is open.
Grock open. And
Kimmy is open, yeah.
Tutu.
Your team is picking.
He's going to be happy.
Bigatron going to be locking in that
Grock Lunox.
Grock Lunox.
Smart bans.
Yeah. Kaya is taken out of the picture,
your
so don't, you have, don't even
picking.
Have to worry about that. RRQ, however, they're going to lock in a tank. Cho here? Cho for the flexibility and maybe another tank. Cho a Kai?
Cho
Akai?
Minotaur.
Thamos also works too. Okay, it's going to be the Thamos.
So they just won. This is going to be, that means this is going to be a tank Cho.
Yeah. Ooh, I mean, revealing it so early on, rather interesting, actually.
They are afraid that Sana plays it, because Sana has been playing Thamos a lot throughout the day. And the only other hero he played is the Lancelot. Mm-hmm. So, and they're written out that one, unfortunately.
Yeah. I mean, Sana, anybody who has been able to be playing Thamos has been controlling the lane as long as he goes up against the Leomord. I think that is for certain. That's just how the matchup goes, but the final pick is going to be
carry
for LY4. Now,
your
third bans have been
banning.
Enabled here. What do they go for?
RQ cannot ban tanks.
Yeah.
Because they need all the tanks available as possible. And BTR will ban a tank. Here, what RQ needs to ban are fighters. What fighter?
Leomord.
I think you ban the Leomord. Yeah.
Yeah. At least then you won't have that huge impact if he does get the momentum. Yeah. Get the momentum. Low enough for the momentum.
Even though Thamos counters it, you still don't want that impact. Oh no, wow.
Your team is banning.
This is a bit weird.
So
BTR,
Bigatron
just ban out, you know, maybe Gatokacha and then pick the Minotaur. Right?
Are they gonna force the Tigreal here? Are they gonna force the Tigreal?
Oh yeah, that's true.
This is gonna be interesting.
Yeah, Bigatron's like, wait, even I don't understand.
Wait, what?
did they just ban their own hero pool? Selena.
Your team
Minotaur.
Is picking.
Minotaur.
Minotaur?
Minotaur. Minotaur. Minotaur's a I mean, Lolita is open as well.
Oh yeah, Lolita is pretty open. I think Lolita might actually
I guess
work
R-
out a
yeah.
bit more.
RQ will pick Lolita. But Mr. V here, he'll go for the Minotaur.
Honestly, I think it might be more beneficial for Bigatron to actually take the Lolita for themselves. However,
no.
Do they want to give up such like a strong team fighting control?
Yeah, they want a team fight control.
Yeah.
Because look at the lineup. They have a lot of hyper carries. Instead of carry and also... And there goes the
Harley
and Lolita.
No? Yes? No? Yes. I mean, maybe...
If he doesn't Lolita, I don't know what else.
so you're going to make a bet there?
Oh, he doesn't Lolita.
I mean, he's holding up. They're really thinking about this, though.
I'm trying to think what else is available. Like Lolita counters Lunox really well as well.
Able to block quite a bit of those projectiles. It's pretty important here.
Lolita. BTR,
your team
what fighter are you
going
to go for? Sana, are you going to go for Lancelot again?
Probably Mardis. Oh no, yeah, your Mardis is still up.
But then you're countering yourself.
I mean, regardless, nothing really can deal with Thamos in general in a solo lane. Maybe, Hayabusa, but then you need to dedicate resources to him anyway. So at least with the Leomord, you don't necessarily have to fight him, and he still has uses in the team fight when it comes by.
I think Ruby was actually a pretty good pick from RSG.
Will that help though? Because I feel like at least with Leomord, you do have the option of getting the Phantom Steed to engage.
I guess this is like a player preference kind of thing.
True.
Even though that means what needs to happen is that they need to make sure that they don't face the same lane. Like, RRQ wants to look for the Leomord lane. Yep, indeedy. With that being said, we have to see what will go on here. We are in from best of one. All hands on deck. The gloves are off, even though I'm not wearing any gloves. This is it.
Yeah, this
both
is
drafts. Who?
I'm liking Bigatron's draft a little bit more. Just a little bit more.
I like RRQ's draft a bit more.
Let's see how they play out. I mean, it's really, at this point, it's our preferences.
This is great because I'm in RRQ. You're in Bigatron.
Yeah.
So, Viva RRQ or hashtag BTR. We'll have to figure out. This is gonna Welcome be an epic game because it's all down to this one. Who's gonna come out on top? Let's figure it out. RRQ on the blue side. Ultron on the red side.
Well, looks like Thamos is. Oh, yes, he is going down to the bot side. They will meet each other there.
That's like. This is what exactly I talked about. You need to do the lane swap and meet that Leomord because if not, the counter just doesn't work out.
Ooh, RRQ punished a little bit. He takes a kind of a bad trade. But it's going to be fine. They kind of conglomerate to the mid side before dispersing to have a good idea of where the lanes are going to be.
So, ooh, interesting start here. They do get the buff. Pretty nice. Pretty nice start coming out. RRQ Lemon will clear it off and hit straight away. Coming through and yep. This is exactly what RRQ wants. But again, it's not too bad for LY4 because LY4 he just wants to farm. However, with Kimi pressuring him, it's going to be a bit harder. Spraying is a little bit hard sometimes.
Yeah, spraying can be a little bit hard sometimes. But now they finally hit into the lane. They kind of understand where everybody is going to be. Going to give over as many of the camps as possible just to help them out before going back into the lane.
Look at Tuturu. He's like so aggressive.
Very, very aggressive. They're going to be trying to take the top crab here. This is going to be important. Liam puts up the shield.
He will back off, but there's one. There's no level 4 just yet. They want to try and reset the crab. They don't get it. And a retribution coming in. Oh, Lemon is here as well.
Yeah, and I am Drago does.
Lemon? Wait, what?
Huh. Huh. Interesting.
Why is Lemon here?
I mean, we saw Lemon move over to the mid lane just to catch the wave as I am Drago and also his support comes around. Oh no, this is bad. This is really bad.
Oh, Liam is there, but they don't want to come. Singh wants to come in. Liam in a heap of trouble. He does have to charge. There's a little bit of this. That's the first blood. Chaos Assault will finish off that kill. So, first blood getting dropped by RRQ. They do have a little bit of momentum. Leomord, he just
sit this one out.
He knows he can't go for it, but there's no minions.
Just has to wait it out completely. There's no point standing under that turret. He has to stay closer to his second turret just to protect himself. He doesn't want to get dove under just yet. Oh, wait, but wait a minute. Looks like there's going to be an engagement.
Oh, BTR first to fall, first to go through. Straight away, Lemon will be able to walk away. This game is really tense.
I mean, you can feel the tension between these two. They don't want to make a mistake here.
James just lingering around for now, finding a way out.
James is looking for a pick here with a Jacundo. Goes in, he sees three people, he's backing out.
Oh, James, he does have the Jacundo. And you know, this is the thing about Cho, he's still really slippery even without the damage reduction. But Tuturu happily farming, honestly. Yes, he did give up a Q in terms of Liam, but at least he's still getting his items. And you can see, this is exactly what Brigatron is doing. They are always swapping the lane around, right? First, they swap it so that the Thamos can meet Leomord, and straight away,
James is trouble.
James will walk away, flanker. He managed to stay alive there. Lemon will play bodyguard for his teammate and clear the way for now.
Machine gun isn't fast enough to get that last darkness onto Chill, but that means BTR is going to pick up the turtle for themselves. RRQ not having anybody there to respond.
See Sana clearing up the wave together with me, Mr. V. Together.
Oh, look at them, they're going to be trading late again!
Yeah, every time, they don't want to miss this. And it's exactly how you need to play this matchup.
This is so nasty. They've adapted so well and they learned quite a bit from tournament itself to make this adaption work out. I mean, is he going back up to the top side? Looks like he is.
For now, I guess he needs to clear one more wave because his bottom lane is still there clearing out the wave as well. So he will, if he rotates now, he will lose a couple of minions. So you don't want that. And Lemon can't really dive him at the moment. Oh, BTR. Want to go for something. James, though, in the Beam of Travel Sync does have the Darkening comes true, but not enough.
Not enough just yet. Oh!
I'm Jago. Oh, Minion Fairy comes true from KPZ, but I am Jago will be dead. Oh, that's a great wraparound from Sync. They get the kill, and now they might go for a
Grop
little bit more. Grop trying to cut the wave, and Liam, he is just a sitting duck.
Help, please. But they notice that the mid side is getting pushed in. They are going to rotate. They're not going to go for this dive just yet. They don't think he's worth it. They lose a mid turret over to RRQ here.
Yep, and now, Sana, this is why you want to dodge the lane, right? You cannot go 1v1. RRQ is very, very close.
Yeah, so far they have complete control, but they're going to keep up the fight.
James getting hovered over, and now no escape coming through. Mr. Free will block it up, but no, there's still a little pop. But RRQ did get it, but here comes Singh. He does have the Chaos Assault. The Machine Gun Maze comes online. They do get 1Q. Tuturu doing what he can.
This is becoming a bit of a struggle here, but so far, Bigatron have gone unpunished for the most part of this game.
Honestly, Bigatron looking good.
Yeah, looking real, real good. I think RRQ are a little bit, you can tell they're a little bit scared to make some of these plays. Ooh.
Brilliance is pop. Mr. V is there. Will he take the space escape back? No. I am Jacko gonna let it through. LY4, though, happily farming away.
Yeah. I mean, he is very happy split pushing by himself. But with the help of Minotaur, just think, watch his Turtle back. I think he should be safe for the most part of it. Takes a safe path, doesn't go through. He knows that Cho is there, so he doesn't want to get caught out just yet.
James, going for it. Just trying to find more. Yeah, that's Cho. So far, the impact of Cho is not that much, but yep, Tuturu needs to...
Yeah, they have to give it up. They see the rotation coming up from the bottom side over here. They know they're on Turtle for sure now, but do they have the numbers? Lolita is getting her way up. They can't do it very fast, so this is going to be a pretty interesting engagement, a 4v4. I have to say so myself.
Whoa, James, Jikundo lands onto two. He kicks onto KZP. That's not the really one. Luminous blocks into four. Are you kidding me, Liam? They don't get the Turtle, though. So far, 1-4-0 exchange to 2-3 hitting shield. A day. Jikundo, where is it? Lands onto LY4. Where's the rest of the team? Oh, I am Jago is there. Looks like James might go down. Oh no, RQ. They're splitting their attention. Oh, great flicker from Mr. Wee. He gets the movement speed buff. Oh my god. Even through that awesome play, RRQ only gets one kill.
Really nicely done by Bigatron. They're pulling the attention away from each other. It's like, oh, you need to look at me, try and kill me, and I'm just gonna make it out of there and pull the damage away from my backline to the front line. Really nicely done by Mr. V there.
Yep, and oh, Lemon. Endless battle first item.
Wants to fight, wants to get right up in your face.
Oh, this is gonna be a damagey downwards.
You gotta be careful here. Oh, you can already see that Bigatron already trying to protect this Leomord here as much as they can.
Oh, here comes James. I wanna go for it. Will not be able to face check it just yet. ETR sync, clearing it out. I am Jago has picked up the lightning charger, so we'll do a little more damage. I think Lemon will finally get his turret.
Yeah, finally gets his turret. I mean, Leomord has to let this go. He's in no condition to fight him.
RRQ still on the hunt, looking for something, but BTR on the other way. James, he has the Shimpo, will be the walkway.
It's gonna be fine for this. They're looking to break that top tier one as well. I mean, but RRQ aren't just gonna let this go. The shield is up. Doesn't take too much damage. Ooh.
KZP is in range from James. Looks for KZP. War pushes him in. Under the turret, but wait a second. This could be a huge mistake. Media Fair only onto Liam. That's not what you want. Now BTR in a really bad position. The beautiful Numenor blast lands onto. And LY4 gets sniped away. Sing to follow. Mr. V, Mike 4 as well. Tuturu comes in clutch with a triple kill. And Harley picking up the fourth one. And RRQ just blew this game wide open.
Yep, they found a perfect opportunity. They've even baited it out. They kicked him, locked him down under the turret. They knew they could take the fight. They had the rotation advantage as well as the numbers, and they take them all the way. Sana.
Oh my god, James! This is insane! The teamwork! RRQ, you're not allowed to do that on stream!
Ooh, got baited once more. RRQ just playing one step ahead of the competition.
That was crazy!
Once he had his ult up, man, that way of the dragon just saved the day. Whew, but it's all planned, you can tell.
Yep, Liam. Clearing true for now.
Thamos goes uncontested for now. James looks like he's going to just chill out for a while down on the bottom side.
KZP is coming true. Liam gonna jump onto it. KZP, there goes a minion free, but Liam is actually really, really tanky. Oh, that burning so much. He will finally go down in the hands of Sing. But now, without those big ultimates, will RRQ want to go for any fight here? Bottom lane, Sana getting pressured around. The way of the dragon will kick him away. I think this is a turret. Will be going down towards the hands of RRQ here. James getting pressured a little bit. They do clear out the minion. So, Mr. V gets a freebie for Sing. BTR getting some straggle kills.
Nah. James again getting caught out once more. I mean, we've seen it happen quite a few times, but he's got to be a lot more careful. The rotation was pretty evident there. Nobody was showing on the map, so the best assumption was that they were making their way towards you.
Mr. V. It's so far, Lemon is just waiting for it. He wants to wait for his cooldown, but they do not go for it. Lemon actually playing super aggressive. He pops his ultimate. He wants to go for this fight, and he has Liam for support. Flicker comes true. Sana and Mr. V wants to try to run away as much as possible. Sana will drop the sweep, but Lemon jumps through. Will get a kill. Sing right on the tail end of it. He does put the cosmic fissure, so it will deter RRQ from chasing.
Looks like RRQ has made a bit of an adjustment for this game. Now Tutoru is going to be matching Bigatron LY Force, push up on the top side while still rotating as much as he can. Looks like they want to play down on the bottom here.
Brilliant, Stas gets popped up. KZP, does he have the Minion Fairy? No, he's forced for go. Oh no, they can't sing, they can't sing. But Minion Fairy will slow things down a little bit. Remember, there's no more Brilliance. And now Sing doing what he can. He gets jumped on, but he does nothing. Aegis still through, coming from the side, doing the damage. BTR, no escape coming out. And RRQ says thank you very much. They'll take the turret, they'll take the kills, they'll take another one.
RRQ again ahead of the competition. We saw that rotation coming through. The moment you saw Tutoru just going down to the bot side, you know that play was coming by.
Tutoru is in full force. He's happy, and James says, I'm sorry, he didn't do a mistake there. But now this could be a costly one because Lord is up.
Lord is up, but again, you gotta be very careful. James is down as Sana is gonna be coming back up, so they're gonna have a numbers disadvantage. They probably have to wait for James to come back up and look for another pickoff before they even consider doing Lord. I mean, they could technically wait two more minutes until Luminous Lord comes by. Might be worth their time.
Nope, I think so too. But now you can see BTR walking up, just doing the Lord. Remember, that's what I talked about. There is a decisive play. James going down, and the rest of RRQ are not even in the neighborhood. Great, great decisive play coming up from Big E-tron.
Gotta play slow. They gotta play slow. Liam's getting caught out here through, trying to pump in the damage.
Oh, they might want to go for it completely whiffing up, and not going to chase just yet. BTR has to force to just back off for now. Remember, no more Minion Fury, but the Lord will be marching top to the bottom lane, guys. Bottom lane, not the mid lane. So RRQ needs to rotate to that side to just clear the Lord here.
I mean, Kazibi, he is still pretty healthy. He's gonna quickly heal up before coming back out. The Lord's gonna be pushing out by itself. They're just sacrificing it here.
Yeah, they can't. Because they still will lose it. If they go with the 1v1 in the top side. Wow, Corrosion Scythe, get bought by Lemon. So Lemon just wants to fully fight out. But BTR, they don't want to give this law for free, I think. Oh, the stun
comes on Sing.
Sing, but he doesn't have the Brilliance, so he can disengage for now. Thamos is on the back line. Oh, Sing, he's not going to go anywhere. He can't escape, and he gets caught out. Thamos is going for it. KZP tags out the four members, and LY4 trying to go for the damage. He takes away James, but can he find a little bit more? Tuturu, though, doing the same. He wants to clear the back line, and 2-2-3, free hitting for days. So far, 1-for-1 exchange for both teams.
1-for-1 exchange. Oh no!
No,
magic. Oh, it's not gonna be enough. It's not gonna be enough. But so far, they're trading pretty equally here. 1-for-1. Lemon trying to get into the back line, but still, this is such a war of attrition. Any kind of lead will be very well used by either one of these teams. They are coming towards the later stages of the game already.
So at least the Lord did take one turret for Bigatron. And it's more important than denying it, I guess.
Yes.
More than taking it.
Yeah. But right now, I mean, they're trying to scale into this game as much as possible.
Holy crystal.
Oh no.
Oh no.
So greedy.
Tuturu is gonna really hit like a truck this game.
He's going for that sheer damage. Wait, something's happening on bot side.
Bot side, Sana in the front lines. He gets caught out. That's dead. That's the Leomord down. No more charge. Here comes the ultimate Lemon in hot pursuit. But what a great Guardian's Bear. It blocks the team off complete. Tuturu gonna slide across the wall. They need to just kill off anybody. Sing getting a full round of damage. And James will knock the Jikundo. But the Minion Fairy is there. Won't charge the boot. And now BTR can chase. BTR can go. And LY4 is in his prime. He's going for it. But RQ has two more members alive.
Into the brush.
Tuturu, he gets the kill. LY4, can you do this? Is this the time for you to shine? The daily magic is there. Can he come true? Tuturu against LY4.
Oh!
He's still staying alive. Tuturu,
no,
Nation Sniper comes true. And LY4 gets sniped down. Tuturu showing that he is indeed the stronger marksman. But at least LY4 bought enough time for his team to come down. Tuturu,
no!
That's a huge mistake. Sana gonna lock on the two.
He can win this.
You go for it. Sana, the counter. He's not confident. He goes for a jump.
Oh,
Lemon forced out the flicker. He cannot go for it. Oh no! That's a huge mistake. And now Mr. V went for the flicker. The wild charge as well. BTR finding a second win, finding a new life.
Oh my goodness, RRQ, you can't do that! You have to remember, Leomord still has the momentum passive. You can't be that low around him. Give him the respect he needs.
Okay, ZP, Minion Fury just cuts the team in half. Liam, there's no escape for you, my friend. And BTR, they have the momentum. They have this in the bag. They can feel it. 30 seconds. They can play this game 4v5 for 30 seconds. As you can see, Lolita is still down.
I mean, this game is really a back and forth here. They're looking, this could be an overextension. They could go for a regroup here.
Oh, James. He goes for a Jukundo, but the brilliance is pop. Looks like they want to go on James, but James is pretty tanky for now. Oh, wow. They are shipping super aggressive here.
They got to back off. Bikatron needs to back off. There's no real need. There's no objective to actually claim across the map. They just need to back off.
And now you can see this game is down to a 50-50 again. Yeah. A coin toss will be the best way to solve this mystery of a tiebreaker.
Yeah, but I mean, both of these teams are playing at their best here. Honestly, any mistakes being made could cost the teamfight at this point of time. There is so much on the line. 15-14. These have been some of the most intense series games of the day.
Yeah, and Sana's here. Divine Glaive. Let's get bought out by IM Jaguar. So it's going to do so much for damage.
Oh, boy. This is just so nerve-wracking. Both teams at each other's throats. This Lord is going to be so important. It's Luminous Lord as well.
Oh, James finds KZB, but that's
he has Rage Form, though.
He does have Rage Form, but he will go down. Now, that means he has no more Rage Form, but James needs to back out of this. KZB took so much damage. Immortality is there, but now LY4 will take James for the first casualty of the fight. Now RQ, one man down, but Sana going to the back line. He finds it. He finds the cutoff date, and RQ, they're losing members left and right. Only two more members alive. The two carries at that.
Yep, definitely was a mistake on James' side. He knew he could kill that person, whoever he kicked, but the problem is that wasn't the prime target.
Oh, I am Jago! He gets LY4! LY4's now at 2-2 is down as well! 12 of the marksman of both teams will fall out. Oh no, sorry, it was I am Jago who died, but 2-2. Oh, can you be the hero that your team needs? Oh no, he's lingering around. Sana going for the chase, but Mr. V, you're so low, you can't do this! Still going for this. Where is the arrow? Where is the ultimate? The Lord is down the
team! You need a block!
Turo! But here goes the Minion Fury! He blocks after Turo! There's no way the Indonesian team can get that from him! And they will secure the Lord!
You saw the desperation in his eyes. He wanted it! Turo wanted to save his team from any retribution there, but KZP able to get right in front of his face, pops out the Minion Fury, they pick up a kill as well as Lord. This is going to be Bigatron's push.
BTR, Luminous Lord to boot. They have 5 members and a dream. Tuturu down on 20 seconds off that cooldown. Let's look at the items really quickly here, Gideon.
Oh boy, the Golden Staff has already been purchased by LY4 as well as Thunderbell. This is going to be, he's going to be dishing out a ton of damage.
Let's look, how many immortalities? There's only 3 immortalities.
They sold it off, they already died a couple
yes,
of times.
Yes, that's true. But BTR, obviously in a little bit better of a position. Tuturu will finally be out, so this last team fight will be a 5v5.
But I mean, Lord's gonna be coming in here. He's gonna try to break this out. Rocket comes through.
Special ability will come through. And look at that Lord. This is on top of a Luminous Lord. This is a
flicker.
No, that's the signal to go. And there goes the Minion Fury. A wild charge to land onto all 4 members of RRQ. To Turudo. That's doing what they can do. What they can. They try to end the game. They can't do this. RY4. They can't do it. No. Oh my god. Talk about a tense ending. But Bigatron Singapore pulls through.
Don't do that! Oh my goodness, that was such a close fight at the end, but Bigatron manages to end it finally!
Let's look at the endgame stats. Let's go to the endgame stats. Best of 4. This means Bigatron Singapore will finish first seed in Group B. But what a game.
My heart.
You know what? Hats off to RRQ. That was a great game.
That was a valiant
but
fight.
BTR, when it seemed like it was all lost, they pulled through like true veterans and true champions.